Mr. Chairman, there are 23 ayes and 14 nays.
The ayes have it, and the report is ordered to be reported to the House. Members will have 2 days to submit views without objection. The staff is authorized to make technical and conforming changes. This concludes the committee's business for this meeting, and the meeting is adjourned.
Well, after a long day of clownishness in Washington, D.C., the House Judiciary Committee has officially held Joe Biden's son, Hunter Biden, in contempt of Congress for not complying with a congressional subpoena to sit for a closed-door deposition last month. Now, as a reminder, Hunter Biden was willing to sit down for a deposition, but he wanted that deposition to be held publicly because he knew that a closed-door deposition would lead to selective leaks of his testimony. And that was intended to, of course, make him look bad. And I don't begrudge him at all for wanting to do the deposition publicly. Republicans should have been in favor of that. What have they got to hide? Don't they want this to be available and transparent for the American people? Now, the vote along party lines sends the matter to the full House of Representatives, which of course is controlled by the GOP, the Republican Party. Hunter unexpectedly showed up on Capitol Hill today with his legal team in tow for this hearing of a different committee, the House Oversight Committee. And it quickly devolved into madness, absolute chaos. Shortly after the hearing began, Hunter and his legal team left, which Marjorie Taylor Greene tried to exploit for her own political reasons. Let's take a look.
Excuse me, Hunter. Apparently, you're afraid of my words.
Whoa.
Oh, wow. That's too bad. I think it's clear and obvious for everyone watching this hearing today that Hunter Biden is terrified of strong conservative Republican women because he can't even face my words as I was about to speak to him. What a coward.
Just as a reminder, few of the things that Marjorie Greene and the majority of members of Congress are not dealing with and instead wasting their time with this dog and pony show instead. Got a housing crisis, we've got an ongoing opioid epidemic, we've got a migrant crisis. We've got so many things taking place, so many problems in our country right now that our elected lawmakers are just fully neglecting as they engage in endless BS hearings and this like ridiculous pursuit of Hunter Biden, who is not a government official, who is not an elected office, and who I don't give a damn about, to be quite frank, because he has no impact on our lives whatsoever. But this is what they were doing in Congress today. Anyway, today's ridiculous fight was about whether or not Hunter Biden should be held in contempt of Congress for not complying with that subpoena. Both the House Oversight Committee and the House Judiciary Committee, which subpoenaed Hunter as part of the impeachment inquiry into Joe Biden, held separate meetings today for this contempt resolution. And of course, they voted in favor of holding him in contempt. And look, it all stems from these allegations that Joe Biden, like that's the real target. It's a politically motivated attempt to go after Joe Biden with this ridiculous impeachment inquiry. House Republicans have been accusing Joe Biden, who I've got no love for. I'm not looking to, you know, needlessly and gratuitously defend Joe Biden. But if you've got the goods proving that Joe Biden illegally sold his influence to enrich himself, then let's see the goddamn goods. Let's see it. But they have failed to show a shred of evidence. And their weird roundabout way of getting to Joe Biden is basically through legal investigations or congressional investigations, I should say, into Hunter Biden, who I agree should not have been on the board of Burisma, okay, Ukrainian gas company. I think Biden did himself a disservice by getting his son jobs that he was not qualified for. And now he is paying the price for that. But again, if they had the goods, John, they would have showed us the goods indicating that Joe Biden has done something wrong, that he has illegally taken money from foreign agents, that he has sold his influence to foreign governments. No evidence of that. And so instead, we move on with this like nonsense investigation into Hunter Biden, which they want behind closed doors. because they want to selectively leak his testimony to make it seem as though there's a there there, when in reality there's no there there. But I don't know, I could be wrong. You might have a completely different perspective. I have no idea. What do you think, John?
Probably not. They want to selectively leak a couple of quotes that make them look strong. They want to leak like a line of them yelling at him, and that's it. They don't want him to be able to respond. That's what Marjorie wants to do, for instance. She, and you saw in that video, has anyone ever wanted more than she wants just to be feared or to be clever or to be like, she just wants and wants and wants to be impressive in a way that she can't actually deliver.
I mean, if she's really wanting fear, I'm sure her lower back fears her after seeing what her workouts look like, but nonetheless, continue.
Okay, I'm not sure where you were going with that. But anyway, that's a pull-up comment. But anyway, And by the way, you mentioned that, you know, Congress, there's a reason people don't have any respect for it. It's because they're not doing anything. And that is true. But like, is any district like as hard up for actual representation as her district? Like, she has been in office 4 years and years and has done nothing. Mm-hmm. If you had like a golden retriever that had been elected member of Congress for that district, it would have done more, because the golden retriever presumably would have been like brought to the district to like, you know, appear in photo shoots at like, you know, like the opening of new stores and stuff. She has done absolutely nothing except tweet and try to host her own podcast. But again, I want to set her aside. On the Hunter Biden thing, you're 100% right. It is just about Joe Biden. Hunter Biden is not involved with Biden on the government side like Ivanka and Kushner was. He's not involved in some sort of Joe Biden business like Don Jr. And Eric are. Like, all of the stuff that they had no problem with Trump's children on both the business and government side doing, all of a sudden with Hunter, it's just this desperate hope that they will find something. And they've got nothing, except as you said, he's used his influence to get him jobs in his life, which means that Joe Biden is guilty of the exact same thing that every single one of them either is already guilty of or is desperately hoping they will soon be able to do. All of them want to use their influence to get people in their family jobs, their contacts, to get contracts with the government, to be able to give speeches and write books that get outsized payments, not in line with what they're actually worth. All of them want to monetize their influence. And Joe Biden seems to have done it less than basically all of the rest of them. And the issue is that they don't need to find anything, because Sean Hannity can just talk about Hunter Biden, no revelations, just talk about it. Mm-hmm. And that is convincing to his viewers. They all think there's something, something laptop, something, something dong pic. That's all they need to sustain interest in this for literally years.
You know, it's hilarious too, because Republicans want to say that there's evidence of wrongdoing by Joe Biden. And so what they're specifically referencing is the most hilarious thing ever. So for instance, Representative Jim Jordan, chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, called Devin Archer's testimony the most telling evidence of the president's potential involvement in an influence peddling scheme. Now, Devin Archer was a former business partner of Hunter Biden's, and he did sit down for a closed door meeting with members of the House committee. And ahead of that, it became pretty clear to James Comer, the Republican chairman of that committee, that Devin Archer didn't have the goods and wasn't gonna give them the testimony that they wanted. So he didn't even show up. He didn't even show up to the testimony, okay? Archer didn't actually back up their accusations and even rejected the idea that Joe Biden had any material involvement in his son's business dealings. Toward the end of his testimony, Archer was asked if it was fair to summarize his entire testimony as suggesting, it's not that Hunter Biden was influencing US policy, it's that Hunter Biden was falsely giving the Burisma executives the impression that he had any influence over US policy. Archer responded, I think that's fair. So you've got that context. You've got the details proving that this is nothing more than a politically motivated dog and pony show that is wasting our time, wasting resources, and doing absolutely nothing about all the various policies that need to be tended to improve the lives of Americans. Okay? And so with that in mind, let's go back to the shenanigans from today. After entering the committee room, Republican Congressman Nancy Mace actually started upbraiding Hunter Biden pretty much right off the bat. Let's take a look.
My first question is, who bribed Hunter Biden to be here today? That's my first question. Second question, you are the epitome of white privilege, coming into the Oversight Committee, spitting in our face, ignoring a congressional subpoena to be deposed. What are you afraid of? You have no balls to come up here and—
Mr. Chairman, point of inquiry.
Mr. Chairman,
if the gentlelady wants to hear from Hunter Biden, we can hear from him right now, Mr. Chairman. Let's take a vote and hear from Hunter Biden. What are you afraid of?
Hold on. Order.
Are women allowed to speak in here or no? Are women allowed to speak in here or no? Because you keep interrupting me.
I'll interrupt the chairman. I don't know that he's a lady.
I think that Hunter Biden should be arrested right here, right now, and go straight to jail.
You know, Cenk ran into Nancy Mace, and Nancy Mace said that she watches the show. And if that is in fact true, I hope she's watching now so she knows that I personally feel that she's an embarrassment, an absolute embarrassment. Like, have some self-respect. Do your job, legislate, pass legislation, improve the lives of your constituents. That little show you put on, when you're looking for an Academy Award, what was that? John, it's just so embarrassing. All of it is so embarrassing. Hunter Biden's sitting right there. You're calling him a coward. He's sitting right there. Like, what? Anyway.
100%. Yeah, because again, they're not interested in what they want to pretend they're going to do is ask him questions that he has no answer for, and they're going to trap him in a box of his own crimes. But they aren't doing that. They're just yelling at him and talking about his balls and sometimes showing his balls, literally.
Oh God.
That's all they're doing, not allowing him to respond. They had no interest in they honestly could have just put up a cardboard cutout of him and they could have shouted at that or whatever and they'd be perfectly comfortable doing it. It's all just for show. And honestly, I blame AOC and Katie Porter and all of the other women in Congress who do amazing jobs of actually trapping people, asking questions that they can't provide good answers for, that make them look terrible. And because that looks so good, all of the rest of them want to do it. But they won't do the work. They don't have the mental acuity, the quick wit, and they don't do the research beforehand. They don't put together the team and actually dig in and find out what has happened. Instead, they just want to shout about balls because they know it doesn't matter. Nancy Mace talking about Hunter's balls is gonna get hundreds of retweets or whatever, and that's what she's here for. It's not gonna do anything, it's not gonna accomplish anything, it's not gonna improve the life of any of her constituents. It'll just flood people's feeds with Nancy Mace talking about Hunter Biden's junk.
When you have a government that has fully conditioned the American people to not expect anything from government, to not expect lawmakers to do their jobs, then all they have to look forward to is this chaos, which is why this kind of stuff gets retweeted and talked about, and there's all this commotion and excitement. This is not governing. This is not a government that is representative of the best interests of the American people, right? Again, you want to go after Hunter Biden for the crimes he's committed? Fine. The whole point of this, though, is to try to justify the impeachment inquiry into Joe Biden. And they know full well that they don't have a case. They know full well that they don't have evidence. And so when you start off from a losing standpoint because you don't have the goods, of course you're gonna look foolish, engaging in what they've been engaging in. And I gotta go to the last video here because to wrap this up, as Hunter was walking out of the committee room, he was hounded by reporters, including one who repeatedly asked him what kind of crack he smokes. And so his lawyer made this brief statement.
Hunter Biden was and is a private citizen. But despite this, Republicans have sought to use him as a surrogate to attack his father. And despite their improper partisan motives, on six different occasions since February of 2023, we have offered to work with the House committees to see what and how relevant information to any legitimate inquiry could be provided.
So because Hunter Biden refused to do the deposition privately behind closed doors and wanted to do it publicly so everyone in America could watch and hear what he had to say. The Republican members of these committees have voted him, or voted and have decided that he should be held in contempt of Congress. Now the House overall will get to vote on that. And since Republicans control the House of Representatives, it's likely they're gonna vote in favor of holding him in contempt of Congress. And then they're going to urge the DOJ to pursue prosecution of him as a result of being held in contempt of Congress. So this is what they're spending their time doing. I want to remind you all that while Republican members of Congress keep like talking about the very real migrant crisis that's currently taking place right now, they're also making it very clear that they don't want to do anything about it, specifically to use that issue as a campaigning tool to basically bludgeon Joe Biden over the head during the election. It's all politically motivated. It's all about them. That's the problem I have. It's all about what can we do to maintain power? What can we do for ourselves in our own political careers? None of this is about helping the American people. Whether you're a Republican, Democrat, doesn't matter. This is all about them, and it's sick.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.